Hello guys, and welcome to this video to learn how to open your CBCT scans on your software programs and how to use them to diagnose and plan your treatments, okay? So the first key point of today is, of course, to choose a good software program, right? So if you want to do an implant planning, for example, or a surgical planning procedure, then you should go for an implant planning CBCT software, which is slightly different. And if you want to do that, then the first link on the description below will be the one for the video of implant planning, where you can find everything about the interface of implant planning CBCT software programs, all right? But here on this video, we are going to talk about DICOM viewers, which are the main ones for oral and maxillofacial radiology. So let's see what they have, and here we are seeing the interface of one of them, but pretty much almost all of them have a similar interface. And then, of course, the first thing that they open is the axial slices. We are seeing the axial slices of a CBCT, and then we have this menu, right? So let's understand what is this menu. We have some options. The first option that you guys are seeing on the menu 3D viewer is the 3D MPR, and that stands for multiplanar reconstruction, all right? So here is the multiplanar reconstruction, and it's the main view for us to see the main three orthogonal planes at the same time. So the axial, sagittal, and coronal planes, okay? Then we have the curved MPR, so the curved multiplanar reconstruction, which is the one that we are going to use to create the coronal panoramic view by putting some points on the axial slice, shaping the future coronal panoramic view that we want to make. We have also some other options, but then the main option for 3D volume rendering is this one that you guys are seeing on the screen, and that's the main one to obtain very nice 3D CBCT reconstructed modules, okay? Like this one, for example. So this image that you guys are seeing is a 3D reconstructed model edited with threshold color addition, and that's why you can even see the teeth and the root inside the bone, and that's a method of the software. Another option that we have is the 3D surface rendering, which is this one that you guys are seeing now, and that allows for exporting files to the STL format, okay? So that's a 3D surface reconstructed model, which is exportable for the STL format. And then we have many other options. We can create regions of interest, we can calculate volumes, we can do all sort of volumetric analysis, as we should always do when we have to do a 3D assessment of the patient, right? But then let's understand about the second key point, which is to start by the axial slices always. So we need first to start navigating through the axial slices, and then we are going to adjust the window level. Window level is basically the adjustment of brightness and contrast. So it's basically the balance between brightness and contrast levels. And we can do this using this tool that you guys are seeing now on the screen, okay? So that's the window leveling tool. And to use this tool, we basically need to hold the left mouse button, and then we drag the mouse to left or to right. So we just move with the mouse in the left or right directions to adjust the contrast, or we move up and down. So in the vertical direction, our mouse, while we are holding the left button, to adjust the brightness. And that's pretty much a method that applies to all DICOM viewers. Then of course, you are going to find the main conditions that you want to diagnose on the multiplanar reconstruction. And of course, the next step is to open the 3D MPR, which is basically the multiplanar reconstruction, right? And now you can see the third key point, which is that we need to centralize and orient all axes of the planes that we are assessing on the anatomical structure that we want to assess, all right? So take a look at this image. We have here the diagnosis of the palatal root of this premolar. So the root canal treatment was performed, and now we are following up this treatment. So we have the three planes, and of course those three planes means that we have three colors. So within each plane, we can find two different axes, which are the axes of the other two windows, all right? So they are basically the cameras taking the pictures that we can see on the other planes. Let's take the orange window as an example. The orange window is basically our sagittal plane, which is of course a little bit tilted to adapt to the dental arch. And now we can see that we have the axis of this plane on the other planes as well, all right? So that's basically what's happening here. We have the axis of the orange window shown on the other two windows. And that applies also for the purple window, which is the axial plane, and the blue window, which in this case would be the coronal plane. Then of course you would repeat the procedure for all the anatomical structures and lesions and alterations that you want to diagnose, but we know that several dentists still prefer to assess everything on 2D files like JPG images, for example. And then if you don't want to use your software to navigate through the images, then you are going to probably receive something like this image here, all right? Which is basically a CBCT converted to the 2D format. This is very simple. Basically, we need to understand that we have those numbers on the row. I'm going to use the number 60 as an example, and the number 60 is basically a cross-sectional slice of the left upper central incisor. And then all I need to do is to find the cross-sectional slice number 60 as well, right? So now I found the number 60, and now I can evaluate the buccal lingual dimensions of this area. So if you guys like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel to see those next videos, and stay tuned for the next videos.